So we've gone ahead and skipped part A, and we're jumping right to part B. You want to get your salt, glucose, and starch solutions, 5 milliliters of each, put them into a beaker, and stir it up. This is going to be our mock blood. It's not red, but you can pretend. We're going to take that mock blood, and we're going to pour it into a dialysis tube that has semi-permeable holes in it. Tie it up nice and tight. We'll save a little bit of that blood and put it into test tube 1. With the dialysis tubing now, we're going to cover it with water, distilled water, so there's no ions, no solutes in the distilled water, and we're going to see if the solutes will diffuse from inside of the dialysis bag out of the dialysis bag. So we've got our 6 test tubes set up here. At 1 minute, we're going to pour a little bit of that surrounding water off into test tube 4. That will let us see if anything diffuses out immediately. Then we're going to let that beaker sit for another 40 minutes. Once that 40 minutes is done, we're just about ready to start characterizing the chemicals in the blood and surroundings. We're going to pour our surrounding water into test tube 6. That was our 40-minute surroundings. Then we'll cut open the dialysis tubing that has that blood inside of it, and we will pour that carefully into test tube 2, which is the blood after. So we have blood before in test tube 1 and blood after in test tube 2. Then we're going to take those test tubes, those samples, and we're going to divide them up into 3 samples so that we can test for 3 different things. So we're going to pour a little bit of solution from that big test tube into 2 smaller test tubes, and we will go ahead and do that for all 6 test tubes. So we have 3 sets of 1, 3 sets of 2, and now we're ready to do the iodine test. So iodine test will be done. This is a test for starch, and it will turn purple if there is starch present. You can see that the first 2, the blood, both turn purple, so there must be starch in there. We'll take a closer look in a second here. So test tube 1, if that makes sense, we put starch into our blood. Test tube 2, starch remains in the blood. No starch in water, that was our control. No starch in our surroundings. Still no starch in our surroundings, and still no starch in our surroundings. If you can think about the size of the starch, it was really big, so it makes sense that it's not in the surroundings. Next, we're going to test for chloride. Sodium is hard to get a good reaction, so we'll just test for chloride instead. We add a couple drops of silver nitrate into each of the test tubes. Silver ions react with chloride ions to give you a white precipitate or a white solid. So we will mix those around and take a look at each of those test tubes in a second. So again, we're looking for chloride here. So it's white, so that's positive for chloride. And still white, so still chloride present in the blood afterwards. Transparent, colorless, no chloride in our water. Surroundings, no chloride initially. But after 20 minutes, now it's that white. And that white solid tells me that some chloride was present, even whiter after 40 minutes. So those are my first 2 tests, the starch and the chloride. Now we're going to work on the Benedict's test. This is a test to see if glucose is present in the solution. So we'll add a couple of mils of Benedict's solution to each test tube. Done that for all 6 now. No reaction yet. They're all this transparent blue to start with. But if I give a little bit of heat to the reaction, that'll speed it up. So we're going to take these over and put them into a large that I've got prepared that's sitting on a hot plate. So we've got some boiling water. You'll see it start to boil in a couple of minutes here. And we're going to be watching for color change. So you can see some of the test tubes are starting to turn kind of greenish and reddish. They're not transparent anymore. You can't see through them. So that means there's a solid there. The colors continue to get darker. Check in your lab manual. There's a list of what percent of sugar the colors correspond to. So we let this heat for 5 minutes, and you can see the colors intensifying in some of them. That is a positive test for sugar. And here is our final lineup of those Benedict's test precipitates. Quick glimpse of the starch test. We'll have longer glimpses of these in a minute. Quick glimpse of the chloride test. And now we're going to just see the results closer up. Again, remember, test tubes 1 and 2 are the blood, and then 3 is water. So we're looking at 4, 5, and 6 on the right there to see if chloride is present. Next up, we're looking at the starch test. So again, test tube 1 and 2 on the left is blood before and blood after, definitely some starch there. Test tube 3 is water, and then 4, 5, and 6 are the surroundings. So you want to think about, did any sugar move into the surroundings? Looking at Benedict's test, results of that glucose test, just a touch of discoloration in test tube 6. Otherwise, it looks like the glucose is largely in the blood. Thanks for watching. Being in lab.